It's Silverstone GP. Yes, I think I'll do Silverstone as well today. What do we have here? Great job out there. We're analyzing the data tomorrow, but from what I saw, you nailed some quick laps. Come by my office and we can take a look at the reports. No, thanks. I don't care. I have them real life on my second screen. okay, I have my notes. So first of all, I want my additional keypad so I can change some things while I'm racing. Second thing, I have some little notes here. For Silverstone, the difficulty should be 111. And that should I should be doing 145 with that difficulty. Let's see. 111. Save it and let's go to the practice. I need water. Something for Silverstone here. I don't think there are any changes to it actually, it's just a placement. Silverstone is quite fast, so fast corners, long straights. I keep the downforce where it is at the moment. That's default fuel, I don't know what I'm going to need. I let them drive because I'll be quite slow to start with. Before I pick up some speed, I think those were all of them. Oh, wait. It's raining straight away. Great. kinda missed that. Wet. 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 And wet. Okay, those are all wets. Going to save it. As wet. The other thing I'm going to do is look into my pit footage. So I have hardened fuel, softened fuel. Let's modify it a little bit. First of all, there won't be any fuel here. There we go. Change the tires, yes. Leaks. I don't remember what it is. I think it's 135, 135, and 1111 at the moment. Then keep it the same. Keep it the same, and we can adjust it later. Okay. Yeah, that's saved. No repairs. There we go. Done. Save that decision. Those are softs. Default empty. All repair. Cool, and wet. So those are the two we possibly may need for the race.
See how the car handles in these wet conditions. We can make some changes to make the car easier to drive.
I think that was way too slow in that right-hander. Hi Majestic, how are you? Yes, round three of Formula Renault. Finally found some time to move the career forward. It was stale for a month. Yeah, Silverstone is not bad. It's quite fast track. I'm quite bored with it because I went to Silverstone, I think, like 5 or 6 times in real life. And it's a bit flat as well. But it's a good track to either watch racing on or to race on, it seems. Oh man, that's quite good. That has to be quite hard car to drive on the truck. But Spa is such a great racetrack. A mile ahead of Silverstone. Lock the wheels there, almost stop in time. I mean, barely. The long one, right? Historic is like much, much longer than the normal one. Yes, that's because of the location. It's in mountains, in a forest. It's beautiful out there. The only problem with Spa is the weather. Okay, I think I'm comfortable with the car and truck. Let's skip to end and move to qualifying. Continue to qualifying. What's the weather for quali? Rain, of course it's rain. Oh, I forgot what the fuel consumption was. So I'm going to trust the game. It's a Yeah, 4 laps should be enough. Let's call it Q for qualifying. It's crazy wet. I need to leave myself some space for the qualifying lap.
Okay, let's get the car in a decent spot for tomorrow's race.
Okay, they are too close now, so there is no point trying to do another lap. It's 151.8 in wet conditions and it's first place at the moment at least. If the race is going to be in the wet as well, I'm going to increase the difficulty. So no one is improving, still in first. I'm curious what are their times, just for a comparison. Wow, they're 3 seconds off my time. That's way too slow. I'm going to skip to end, they're not going to improve enough to beat my time. And I'm going to check now what are the conditions during the race. If it's wet, I'm going to increase the difficulty. Light rain. Okay, so I'm going to exit. And I still don't know what my fuel consumption was. That's great. I can actually check it easily. Okay, so. Okay, so. Opponent skill level 113, up from 111 for quali. AI was much slower in quali at 111. 111 was tested under dry conditions and quali was in wet. AI was slower in wet than in dry. The race starts in wet, so that's why I'm rising it to 113. Safe, start. 20 laps, 20 laps, no pit stops, hopefully. One fuel tank, one set of wet tires, at least that's the idea. The tires, especially the left front, the other not, but the left front is has a high wear on this track. Let's load that wet setup. There we go. Double check it. Okay. One thing I want to change. So I reduce the brake pressure. This is in tandem. This is working with my load cell at 40. I'm going to increase the fuel load. I'm going to need 82 liters probably, but I want to have a bit more. So 85. Now, in case the weather gets better, I want to have a soft pit strategy. So to change tires to soft. Let's start.
Okay, mate, focus on the light. Nothing else matters now. Let's get a clean getaway and defend that pole position.
Not right. A good start.
Clear. Right side, on your right side. Clear.
There is one on right, I think.
Got a car right. Right side.
Wow, he went sideways.
Car right. Half length behind.
Behind? He's in front. Oh, shit! Uh, 79% damage. That little touch. He jumped in front of me, braked. I braked too late. 79% damage. Huge. I'm going to restart this session. No, one more try. Better start this time. A quicker upshift to second gear. Staying in first. Didn't have chance to test or to train. Starts in wet conditions, so that first start was horrible. The second was much better. Keeping the first position with just a half second advantage, and less, he's in a slipstream. Right behind me, all of them. And he's in slipstream.
Half length back, what do you like?
He's coming on the left-hand side. I don't know if just next to me or behind me.
There now. He's 2 lengths behind you.
I went safely there in those corners because AI can and will attack in dangerous places like these corners. I don't think this is the best place to attack. I would never do it in multiplayer there, for example. Expected at this stage. I think there was a change of position behind me. A huge difference between 111 and 113 skill level. At 111 they were losing around 2.5 seconds per lap, at 113 they staying behind, right behind.
Half leg back. One leg back. Two legs back. One, two lengths back.
You're clear. really bad left corner. Conditions are getting worse. The truck is more flooded than it was at the beginning of the race, so we have a puddle here, another one here, a small one, aquaplaning into these puddles. So good that I can change the gears up and down with just one hand on this wheel. So at least I can have the drink. So as soon as those conditions, the weather conditions, got worse, and the track became more flooded, and we have puddles now. The AI pace got worse. Oh, there is a puddle here on the inside of that corner. I have to be careful there. Going too close to the apex can cause a spin. Also, it looks like AI is not affected by puddles in Project Cars 2. At least that's my experience with it. I'm building a nice advantage, which is crucial, because if that weather changes again and becomes better, they will become much, much faster. And that's something I have to be prepared for. That was too aggressive. Force feedback reacts with puddles quite nicely. Generally, Project Cars 2, in my opinion, is the best force feedback of all the PlayStation available scenes. So, comparing to Assetto Corsa and Assetto Corsa Competizione, though I haven't tried Assetto Corsa Competizione on PlayStation 5 after the update. Maybe the force feedback got improved, but in the original for PS4, it was really bad. Well, maybe not, maybe it wasn't really bad, but it wasn't good. And I'm always using the Fanatec Fanatec recommended settings for all the sims per platform. I like the force feedback in Project Cars 1 too, but it was really hard to set up. There was so many settings, it was crazy. And it required quite some time, and there wasn't really one recommended settings. Everyone had to kind of set it up for one's liking.
Your best sector 2 today. set your own personal best lap. Sit up.
Feels like the weather conditions are improving. It's not raining anymore. That's the pub that I was talking about earlier. Halfway through, the front tire is 26% down. That's a lot.
Fastest first section you've done so far. Great stuff.
Bit too deep into that apex, but it's okay. Again. So it looks like I'm keeping the advantage I built so far. I think I started losing that time a little bit. Last time around here I had around more than 9 seconds, now I have around 9 seconds. That's the time I'm reading from my dashboard, not from the timetable which is visible on the screen.
That's your best second, time so far today. Great stuff.
Interesting, but such a waste of time. That costed me around 3 seconds. Thirty-two percent tire usage on the left front. That's on 14th lap, which has just started. Yeah, but it's not because I'm getting faster, but it's because the conditions are getting better. I'm slowing too much and I'm going too deep to that corner. It's around 4 seconds advantage at this stage. 4.5 now. Five more laps. The left front is now yellow with 62%, so 38% used. It's now only 3.5 seconds advantage, so it's going down. AI is catching up. That's why it was so important to build that advantage at the first phase of the race, though that big slide costed me around 3 seconds. The front left. There is now a prominent dry line in some places of the track, in some sectors. Three laps to go. two laps to go. That was my fastest lap, but AI is faster. Seconds advantage, 3.7, 3.8. It's a good advantage to have at that stage. Even though the truck is drying, there are still some places where there are puddles of water. And this is going to be our final lap.
Just at your own personal best fastest lap. Keep it up. Not far to go now, just the last lap. Keep on it all the way to the flag. Come on, we can win it.
My advantage dropped below 3 seconds now. The front left is now 45% used. That was too deep. I think I'll get, yeah, slow down stuff.
On this win, you're gonna have to take it. Push as hard as you can.
Oh, I can see some drops, so it looks like it starts raining, but it doesn't matter now because those are the last two corners. One more final corner and it's a win. With just around 3 seconds advantage. I can see them in my mirrors. ...3.4 liters of fuel left, that wouldn't be enough for one more lap. My teammates in P2. That would be pretty cool. The final usage on the left front tires was 46%. Almost halfway through. Done and dusted. 2.9. That was close. No, yeah, it is my teammate, roughly. So it's team D-Box 1 and 2. Doesn't happen too often in the game. Best lap, I had 47.96, 47.52. So my teammate was a good, almost half a second quicker. Almost. The third one was had better best lap. Fourth one. Fifth one, seventh one, eighth one had an amazing lap. I think that may be the fastest lap. And the ninth, they were, well, my lap was horrible. They definitely became quicker when the conditions changed for better. Yeah, so 1:47.321, that's the one who was eighth, had the best best lap. They don't give points for best laps in that series anyway. So it doesn't matter that much. Bandai Namco Entertainment, interesting. So the publisher has its own team in that series. Team D-Box, second driver, is in the fifth at the moment, which is not too bad. I think hopefully he will improve. As a team, we have a good advantage. Good. Well, that is going to be it for today, or for now at least. Let's see what the next race is. The next race is Red Bull Ring. Okay, a track is just good enough. I need to find a proper difficulty for the AI for the track, which I'll do offline, not on the stream. No point wasting time, your time, not mine. I have to do it anyway. So thank you all for watching and have a great afternoon. And see you next time.